The MrExcel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from MrExcel podcast episode 1689. Import Dropbox file list to Excel. Hey, welcome back to the MrExcel netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. We're going to use Data Explorer again today, but to solve a real life problem. My real life problem is my Dropbox is almost full. They'll tell me up here that I'm using 13.1 gigabyte of 13.75 gigabytes used, but they don't give me any good way to search through the folders. And luckily for me, I have the client installed, so all of those files up in the Dropbox are actually stored here in a cache. You know, this is the emergency cache. In case the internet goes down, I can still get to these files, but I'm going to use this. So we have this folder here. I'm going to copy that, and we'll go back to Excel. Now, hey, this Excel 2010 and Excel 2013, you can get Data Explorer for free. Before this, I've written VBA to do this. Also, our sponsor, Easy Excel, has a utility. So you can go to easy-excel.com and download the trial from there. But let me show you how to do this with Data Explorer, because there's one interesting glitch. So we go to Data Explorer, from File, Import metadata and links about files in a folder. Ah, this is really cool. A nice thing that they added there to the end of the from file. All right, so I'm going to paste the folder path and click OK. All right, there we go. So here's our file name, the extension, date. Ah, but you know what's missing is the file size. And they have something here called record. But that doesn't seem very useful. But I did notice that there's a very interesting icon up here that looks like, I don't know, I'm going to call it the expand icon. So I'm going to left click that, and you'll see that there are a whole bunch of attributes. This must be like a child record or a set of child records. So I'm going to uncheck select all columns and choose size and click OK. And we now get attributes.size loaded there. Click done. And I now have a complete list of files. I can sort this, figure out which the largest ones are, which ones maybe I'm not using anymore, and use that to clean up my Dropbox. Data Explorer, beautiful new tool. It's still in preview, but it's free. You need Excel 2010 or Excel 2013. Hey, just a quick postscript. For those of you who actually have a Dropbox that's too full, here's what I discovered once I had all that data in Excel. So 673.1 megabytes, remember that number. If you have a shared folder, even if someone else created that shared folder, so Scott created the shared folder and shared it with me. Now, I always figured that was his file in his space, but that file counts against both of us. So inside of here, there is a file that's, you know, 300 megabytes or something like that. And so what I had done, and what I'd been doing a lot, is I would choose that folder, shared folder options, and say that I wanted to leave that folder. Click leave folder. All right, and I never paid attention to the fact that the folder stayed there. Okay, and what's actually happened now, if we go back and look at accounts again, the number of shared files and regular files has switched, but I still have 673.1 megabytes of files left. So what I found I had to do was, now that it's no longer a shared folder, these are all personally in my Dropbox. Normally I wouldn't have wanted to delete this because I would be afraid that it deleted from the folder for Scott. But once you make it be not shared, then you can delete. And now when you look at accounts, the file that you unshared actually comes out of the amount, out of the account. And I called Scott to make sure he still has the file in his Dropbox. So it's all just very strange. And if you ask to see deleted files now, it says that you deleted the shared folder, you know, which makes you think that you deleted it for the other person. So it turns out I had 13 gigabytes of files. Most of those were shared, not even files that I knew were there. I just had to leave those shared folders and then delete my personal copy. Really confusing. More confusing than VLOOKUP when you get right down to it. All right, there we go. Well, hey, thanks for stopping by. See you next time for another netcast from MrExcel.